Hello. Today the voice one of those perps started to, one of those Voice2Skull, they was giving me impulse in my I hear a little, noise. I don't know what to call it. Like whatever, but it's like non-lethal weapon, which includes a neuron electromagnetic device which uses microwave transmission of sound onto the skull of persons or animals by way of pulse modulated microwave radiation, and a silent sound device which can transmit sound into the skull of a person or animal. Note: the sound modulation may be voice or audio subliminal messages. That's what I had, subliminal messages. One application of V2K is use of electronic scarecrow to frighten birds in the vicinity of airports. Well, anyway, I had it done to me subliminally. And they were talking to me about childbirth. I'm not having nobody's baby, okay? I'm not having nobody's baby because the world, for me, is too much. Because what I'm going through, I don't want my child to ever go through that. So I won't have any kids. It's on me. Everyone's different. But there's this lady. She was crying, like, kind of, because she can't have any kids. And then she starts saying, oh, she's not worthy. I'm just watching her on YouTube. She's not worthy. But that's not true. Because these perp people, they're in our bodies 24/7. Probably hers, most likely. That's why I'm doing this video. And they probably made her infertile. So if you notice, there's a lot of infertility these days. Not because it's the food that we're eating. They got those laser magnetic stuffs pointed at our private parts that could zap you into infertility right off the bat. So you'd be trying, having, you go to infertility clinics all the time and take your IVF and all that stuff, and you don't get no babies. You've been trying for years, the doctor's helping you, because these wicked people, perp people, are just zapping your body parts, your private parts, your vagina or your penis or a man, your stomach region, and then you don't get no kids. That's why people ain't have no children. I have to tell people that. So don't be thinking God cursed you or you're cursed or a witch. So all you people harassing these women out there, it's not right. You people could have children, but the powers, the wicked people that are, we have to deal with, are purposely not letting you have babies because they don't want you to reproduce. They're into population control and they don't feel you're worthy of having children for whatever reason. They decide who they not our God, but they think they are. They like to act like it. And then they target your body. Yes, they are targeting your body. You don't even know what's going on, but I'm telling you. And then you can't have kids, and you go to IVF, and you try to get your kids, and it don't come out. You wonder how I paid all this money, and I still can't get it. This technology works, right? But if they have other higher power that could intercept that stuff, it ain't going to work. So you'd be wasting your money. And I think it's just wrong. Because some people really do need to reproduce. I'm not one of those people that need to reproduce. But there are people out there who need to reproduce. Because how else the population going to continue? Not me. Because anyway, so back to me. So today that subliminal voice asked me if I would be a willing participant to one of their studies. They already have the technology where you could have kids without eggs and sperm. Yeah, Japanese, Japanese always doing stuff. So here, and then in Israel too. And then this one is about older eggs in women. They can make it younger again. So the people who have troubles with fertility because their eggs are too old. Well, a company in Jerusalem. Here's the article, and they are reversing the motility of the eggs, I guess you could say. All this, but what the person asked me is, where's my article? I gotta find it. One moment. Okay, here's the article. Creating embryos in the lab, how and why, what the future holds. So they already made babies like this, but they're not telling us the truth. This article is dated, August 16th, 2022, last year. They already have this technology. They want me to have a the subliminal whacked out person wants me to have a baby with one of their people, and they're gonna use the skin technology, and they're bugging me. They keep telling me subliminal, have a baby with the skin and you know, have it via skin. Cause I'm not having none of y'all babies. They say, okay, you don't have to have it, we take your skin. So they want to go and take my skin and against my will. What is this? Yeah, against my will. They do everything against my will. So here, I'll just read it quickly. Creating an embryo from cells other than sperm and egg cells and growing them outside the uterus is already an area of study that has developed significantly over the past 5 years. Blah, 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 blah. So they're taking cells and your skin. Oh, wait a minute. Okay, I found the article. There's a lot of articles. Anyway, this one is this year. It says April 25th, 2023. I wanted one that's relevant to this year because we're in 2023. Anyway, the article says, beyond IVF, scientists debate ethics of human reproduction without egg and sperm. They already have this technology. And they want me to be a guinea pig and have me, my skin. That's what the subliminal thing is telling me. I'm not doing that. So I'm just putting this out there. So if it's against my will. I just have to do this video. What could I say here? Well, I'm trying to read it. It's called The Approach Goes Beyond In Vitro Fertilization, which is combines egg and sperm in the laboratory. No, called IVG, promises to someday provide a more cure for many types of infertility, to slow the biological clocks and to enable the kind of embryo. They use the skin and hair and cells and whatever. But I mean, the audacity to tell me, to ask me. They keep bugging me, but they shut up now. I said, I'm not doing this. I said, I'm going to do a video, and I can't know. You people out there could say I'm out there. I'm schizo. Whatever you want to call me. But this is what's going to happen. I'm explaining it quickly. So if they see that you are, they select you as having a reproduction, that you have some characteristic that they like, they're going to go against your will and get your skin cells, your hair, from your hair, from whatever they could get it, and make a baby with their people. That's what's going on. And they want to do that with me. And that's what the silly subliminal Voice2Skull thing was telling me. And I said, I'm not doing that. So they said, we're going to do it anyway. So they're telling me. And not even asking me. They say, we're going to do it. I said, I'm not going. That's against my will. So that's the future. So against your will, people, they're going to go, if they like whatever you got going on in your characteristic or your body or whatever, I don't know what they're looking for. They're going to go get your cells, even from your spit, your saliva, or whatever. They're going to combine it with whoever they want to and make you your prodigy. Yeah, that's so I just put it out there. That's what's going on. It's already in the head. I just show you all these articles. They already do it. When you see they have these articles, it's already done. And they already made it because the guy told me that they already made these people. It's already existed, but they can't let the population know right away. They do the little bits. They tell us they're scientists. No, when you start seeing it says scientists, they already done it. They all told me. That's what the subliminal thing says. We already have these people already made. Cloning, whatever you want to call it. I don't know. But now they could just swab you, scratch you and get on their fingernails or whatever they're going to do. They're going to, you know, get your DNA or your little skin cells. When you have dead skin cells fall off of you, then they could just reproduce you with, you know, that's going to, so we got to walk around with plastic clothing. So they don't, I don't know what we're going to do. And don't matter how old you are, they're telling me right now, don't matter how old you are, as long as you got, I even think dead people, they could go on dead people's cadavers before they turn into bone. Maybe even bones from bones. I don't know. They might even be able to do it from bones. So, back to women who have problems, who are infertile. Those women, they need this technology. Because this lady here, she says she's from Africa. She paid. It's called this article. I was just reading it about it. They call them cursed Africa. You know, if they don't have kids, they consider the family cursed, and they beat them up and they kill some of them. This lady took all her money, was $4,500, from Tanzania, and it didn't work. And the reason why it didn't work, because the perp people in her community made it didn't work and made her lose all her money. She sold her farmland and her animals. It's terrible. All her stuff, she sold her land, she said. She's from Uganda. Where did it say? Here you go. And laments the high cost of IVF. My husband is not supportive at all. He knows he could have more children from other relations if he wants. She sold all of her land and inheritance to pay for one cycle at a cost of $4,900. Sadly, it was not successful. At this rate, it will take me another 9 years to save enough money for a second cycle, and by then I will be too old. We cannot afford it. I'm going to die without my own biological child. This is her problem. She says, I am going to die without my own biological child. And it's sad news, because over there, in many nations around the world, they consider women who don't have children to be cursed, and they treat them like witches and blah, blah, blah. So they need this technology of the skin, because they can't afford it, because they said the doctors who perform the IVF are from foreign countries like the U.S., and, you know, they need their money. So that's why it cost her all that money, and she don't have all that money, so now she's, like, poor, and all the other women who going through this. And they said the eastern part of Africa is infertility. They're having a problem with infertility in the eastern part of Africa, Uganda area or something like that, and some other places over there. Some parts of the West Africa is more fertile, but over there they're having some issues. You know why? Because these perp people are over there zapping them, so because they don't like, I'm not going to lie, they don't like black people. The ones who's in charge don't like black people. So they try to kill us. I'm black. They try to kill us as much as possible. Even in the United States, when you have a baby these days, you get a C-section. Sometimes you don't make it out of that C-section. Because it's all conspiracy around the world to kill off us black folks. I have to say that, because the black women and the men. But if you notice, a lot of black women who get C-sections, they have a lot of issues, or they don't make it out of that situation. So anyway, so these guys is going over to Africa now with the technology and killing off all their cells. They're zapping them in their bellies and their stomachs or whatever, however they go about it. And the people are infertile. But now they got the other guys who are going to get to unfertile, worry about the eggs and the sperm. They're going to be using the skin. So that's going to solve the problem, so these women don't get treat like curses and witches and all that, and destroying them and burning them. How they treat them. They're still old school over there in the other part of the world. Not only Africa, Asia, although a lot of places, if you can't have a children, old school, stupid mentality. But I think this is good about the skin stuff to help those women who feel that they need to have kids. But for the other people who are doing it to make pure race people who they want, because they see you have some characteristic, that's not right. Like, they something about me, I don't know what it is, but they like to annoy me. And they want my genes. I don't know why they want to be bothering me. They be telling me that. And because I be really resisting them all these years, they said I'm very strong. I created some kind of immunity. Like that lady that named Locke, that lady with the cancer gene back in the days. Yeah, I have my body now has got strong. And all you people out there who are resisting, y'all too is also strong. So that's why they're monitoring us. Because they said one day they might not be able to go and get a drug to do something. So all us target people that they're using against, will we have the ability to fight whatever they're putting on us? Because we've been struggling with it for years and we're still standing. That's what that guy told me. So they're keeping me around as an auxiliary. That's why I'm not dead. Because, you know, they can kill me any day. But because I got my genes is strong, and all you guys out there, that's why they're keeping us around. Because they know one day the drugs that they're using is going to turn against them. And the only people who's going to survive are people who are living with it, like me and you. So that's why they didn't kill us. They didn't bump us, so they didn't kill us off yet. I just tell you, yeah, they be telling me right now what I'm talking to you. Yeah. Call me schizo, friend. You know, I don't really care what you call me. I don't care what you call me, because I got to tell people what's going on. You can listen and don't believe me. But it's happening. And then subliminal, all this subliminal. They call it voice to skull and all this nonsense. Yeah. I don't know. Anyway, so it's good in one way, the reproductive cycle for women who need to have kids, with who can't have it because the people zap their body and they think they're cursed. It's good. And then it's bad for the ones who want to be like having the perfect race. And they're going to find whoever they want. And then against their will. Man, we're going to be body snatchers. It's going to be like body snatchers. You got to run around and run, hide from these people. And it don't matter how old you are. Don't matter. You say, oh, I wait till I get old. They're not going to. No. They're going to, as long as they sell, they can reverse your cell and make it younger. They can do all these wicked things they're doing now. Anyway, that's all I have to say. Thanks. Have a nice day.